Hello friends, welcome to Insight Learners. So in this video we shall discuss the KPIT aptitude questions. So these are the previously asked questions and many questions are repeated. We shall quickly see the aptitude part, which consists of the quantitative aptitude as well as logical part. So in the next video we shall discuss the English part as well as the verbal as well as the programming MCQs or MCQ questions on C language. So we shall quickly see the first question, that is the aptitude part. A student scores 55% of person marks in 8 papers of 100 marks each, and if he scores 15% of his total marks in English, how much does he score in the English? So this is the question which is given. We need to, so first we shall quickly write what is the given. So the given is that the student scores 55% marks in 8 papers out of 100 marks each. So student scores 55% in 8 papers of 100 marks, in 8 papers of 100 marks each. So each paper is of 100 marks and he scored 8. So he scored 55% of 100 marks. And next thing is that he scores 15% of his total marks. So first we need to calculate what is the total marks. So total marks is equal to 55%, that is 55% of, so 55% into 8 into, so 8 papers he wrote which consist of 100 marks, so which is equal to, so 55% is nothing but 55 divided by 100, which is 0.55, so into 800, which is equal to 440. So similarly, the next thing is 15% of the total marks in English. So he scores 15% of the total marks in English. So English, so 15% of total marks. So 15% of total marks is nothing but it is 440. So which is equal to 15% is nothing but it is 15 divided by 100. So into 440. So which is equal to, so 15 is nothing but it is 0.15. into 440, which is equal to 66. So 66 is the, that is the marks scored in English. So the question is simple, how much does he score in English? So you can say he scores 66 marks in English. So from the option you can say the option B is the correct answer for this question, which is 66. So then we shall see the second question. There are 40 students in a class, out of which there are 14 who are taking maths and 29 who are taking computer, and it is based on probability. So what is the probability that a randomly chosen student from this group is taking only the computer class? So total there are 40 students. So total there are 40 students, out of which they have told 14 choose. So 14, so maths is, the 14 students takes maths as well as computer class is 29. So computer is 29. So here you can say, if you add the maths as well as the number of students who take maths as well as the computer, if you add, it will be 43. So there are totally 40 students. So 43 minus 40, if you do, you will get 3. So you can say there are 3 students who chooses both the subjects, that is maths as well as computer. So what you need to do is, but here we need only the probability of computer. So for the computer, what you will do is, so computer, it will be equal to, so 29 students minus 3, which will be equal to 26. And now we need to find the probability of the students. So probability with respect to, so probability of the randomly chosen student from this group who is taking only the computer class. So computer class is 26 divided by probability is the total number of students, which is 40. So which will be equal to 26 divided by 40, which is equal to 13 divided by 20, and which is equal to the percentage, which is 65% is the correct answer for this question. So from the answer, that is from the option, you can see the option C, that is 65% is the correct answer for this question. So then we shall quickly see the third question, which is based on the logical reasoning. So here they have told, if A runs faster than E, so initially they have told A runs faster than E, but not fast as D. So but not fast as, it should be B. So but not fast, it should be B, and this is D, but not fast as B. So A runs faster than E but not fast as B, means B will come first, and in the second second statement they have told D runs faster than C. So there is a D who runs faster than C, and but not as fast as B. So but as not fast as B, so it means the B comes here. So then after that, the person who runs the fastest is, so B is here. So out of all, you can say that D runs fastest. So D runs fastest. So you can say option D, that is fourth one, option D is the correct answer, which is nothing but D runs fastest among all. So then we shall see the fourth question. There are 200 questions and the time is 3 hours, out of which 50 questions. So out of which 50 questions are from maths. And next thing is that if the time allotted for maths problem is twice of that others, then what is the time which is required for one math solution? So again here the given we need to find. So there are totally 200 questions and out of which the time is 3 hours, out of which 50 questions are from maths. So out of 200 questions, so there are 200 questions. So we shall see the solution for this. So first thing is there are 200 questions. So there are 200 questions, out of which 50 questions are from maths. So 50 questions are from maths. 50 questions from maths means out of 200, you can say 50 questions are from maths. So 200 minus 50, you need to do, which will get 150. So next thing is, they have told if the time allotted for the maths problem. So if the time allotted for the maths problem, if it is twice of that others. So if it is twice of that others, then what you need to do is, what is the time required for one math solution? So totally there are 50 questions in math. So if the time allotted is twice of that, so it will be 50 into 2, so which will be equal to 100. So which will be equal to 100. So then after that, so here it is 100 and then 150. So what you need to do is, what is the time required for one math solution? So what is the time which is spent in order to solve one math solution, you need to find. So here we have 100 plus 150. So 100 plus 150. 100 plus 150. So 100 plus 150. So which is equal to, so 100 plus 150. So 100 divided by 150. So here you can say 100. 200 minus 50 is nothing but 150. And 50 into 2 is 100. And next thing is that you're going to add the both. So 100 plus 150. Then divided by 100 you are supposed to do. So then divided by 100. So then it will be 250 divided by 100, which is equal to 2 divided by 5. So which is equal to 2 divided by 5. And then here they have told 3 hours. So they have told 3 hours. So 60 into 3, 180 units. So here they have told 3 hours. So you are going to find it in minutes. So we have 2 by 5. So 1 hour equal to 60 minutes. So 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. But they have told 3 hours. So 3 hours is equal to. So 3 hours is equal to 60 into 3. So it will be 180. So 180 minutes. So out of 2 by 5 into 180 you need to do. So 180 into 2 divided by 5. So 180 into 2 divided by 5 will give us the result. So which is equal to 72 minutes is the correct answer. So 72 minutes is the correct answer for this question. So option will be provided and I did not mention the options in this question. So try to solve the questions without the option and then find the mark the correct answer. So next thing is, we shall see the fifth question. So 15 liters of a mixture contains 20% of alcohol. So the total amount of mixture is given as 15 liters of mixture. So total amount of mixture is 15 liters. So total amount of mixture is equal to 15 liters. And next thing is, if it contains 20% of alcohol, so what is the alcohol content? So alcohol is nothing, so 20% of alcohol, that is 20% of alcohol, that is 20% of alcohol is present in 15 liters. So which is 20% of 15 liters, so which is equal to, so 20% is nothing but it will be 20 divided by 100 into 15 you are supposed to do. So which will give you, so 20 divided by 100 into 15, again you will get the 3 liters. you will get 3 liters, and then in the rest question and the rest water, 3 liters of water is mixed with it, and what is the percentage of alcohol in the new mixture it would be. So there is a water, so water, so out of 15 liters, 3 liters of water is mixed. So 15 liters minus 3 liter of water is mixed. So 15 minus 3 you are supposed to do, which is equal to 12 liters. Then after that, what you are going to do is you need to find the, so there will be 12 liters. So then after that, here you need to find the percentage of alcohol in the new mixture. So what will be the total amount of mixture? So this is 15 minus 3, it will be 12 liter, and then after that, total amount of mixture will be equal to, so what you are supposed to do is you need to do, so percentage of alcohol which is present in the new mixture. So there is 3 liters, so 3 divided by 12 into 100. You are supposed to do 3 divided by 12 into 100. So here they have told 3 liters of water is mixed with it. So if it is mixed with it, then you need to add it. So this will be 18 liters. So this will be 18 liters. So you're going to do, so there is a 3 liter of alcohol. So 3 divided by 18. So 3 divided by 18 into, you want in percentage. So into 100, which is equal to 16.67% will be the correct answer for this question. So answer is 16.67. So then the next question, that is 6th question. So that is 6th question is, for every correct answer, 4 is awarded, but for a wrong answer, 2 is deducted. So for every correct answer, you are going to, that is 4 is awarded, and for every wrong answer, 2 is deducted. Then if there is total 150 questions, so if there are total 150 questions, then after that, what you are going to do, and then Sukanya scores 480, how many answers of Sukanya were correct? So first thing is the total marks. So first thing is that we need to find, so there are 150, there are total 150 questions. So for every correct answer, 4 is awarded, means 150 into 4 you are supposed to do, 150 into 4, so which will be equal to 600. Then after that, for every wrong answer, 2 is deducted, and then here what happens is that, and Sukanya scores 480. So out of 600, she scores 480. So you need to find the 600 minus 480 is nothing but, it is 120. So the number of incorrect answers is nothing but 120. So there are 120 incorrect answers, and then that will be divided by 6, because for every correct answer it is 4, for every wrong answer 2. So 4 plus 2 will be 6. So 120 divided by 6 you are supposed to do, which you will get as the 20. So then 20, then after that, so what is the number of correct, so for if there are total, so if there are total is 150, then minus 20 you are supposed to do, 150 minus 20 you are supposed to do, which will be equal to 130. So you can say 130 is the number of correct answers. So you need to find how much correct answer did Sukanya get. So answer for this is 130 is the correct answer for this question. So then 7th question, there are 200 questions in a on a 3 hours examination. So this is the repeated question, earlier we have solved. So there are 200 questions in a 3, so this is the same question, so the answer is 72 minutes. So this is the repeated question, so which answer for this is 72 minutes. Then the next one is 8th question, in a class which is composed of X girls and Y boys. So X girls and Y boys, if they have mentioned X girls and Y boys, means it will be X plus Y, because AND is there of the class. Then what part of class is composed of girls? Of girls is nothing but, it is X, of is there. So what part of class is composed of girls? So X of is there, so it will be X divided by X plus Y. So the answer is option C, that is X divided by X plus Y is the correct answer for this question. So then after that, the next one is, so the next question is that if 9X minus 3Y if it is equal to 12, and 3X minus 9Y if it is equal to 7, then 6X minus 2Y is equal to question mark, then 8, 9. So you need to find what will be the place, so in the place of question mark, which value will come, you need to write. So first thing is, we are going to, So here we have 9x minus 3y is equal to 2. We shall write it as x is equal to. So 9x, first we shall write 9x is equal to. So 3y goes here, it will be 12 plus 3y. So it will be 12 plus 3y. Then after that we need find x. X is equal to 12 plus 3y. So 12 plus 3y divided by 9. So 12 plus 3y divided by 9. And now we shall substitute it in the equation, that is 3 into. So 3 into x. So x is nothing but it is 12 plus 3y divided by 9. So 3y divided by 9. Then after that into, then minus 5y is equal to 7. Minus 5y is equal to 7. So then you need to find the value of y, and then after that substitute that value of y in the value x. So y will be equal to 1 divided by 2, and then after that we need to substitute the value of y in the equation. So that is x is equal to 12 plus. So 12 plus, so we're going to substitute the value. First find the value of y, then after that substitute in it in the equation x. Then after that find the 6x minus 2y. So after that 6x minus 2y you are supposed to find. So 6x minus 2y is equal to question mark. So what will come in place of 89, they are told. So first find the value of y, then find the value of x, and then substitute it in the equation. So upon doing this you will get the answer as 8. So that is option D, 8 will be the answer. So then the next 10th question. So 10th question is that the MMN agrees to purchase a gift for rupees D. So if there is a MMN, so MMN purchases gift. So MMN purchases the gift. So purchases gift for rupees D. For rupees D. Then after that, if 3 men drop, how much more will each have to contribute? So there is a drop of 3. So if MMN agree to purchase a gift for rupees D, so which is equal to, so you are going to write it as MMN who agrees to purchase a gift for D. So that is D divided by M. Then after that, next thing is that if 3 men drop, so if 3 men drop means M minus 3, so it is D into D into, so D divided by, so D divided by, then after that the next one is M minus 3. M minus 3 because 3 men drop to contribute towards the purchase of the gift. So therefore if 3 were dropped, so what is the, you need to find the answer for this. So if 3 men drop, out of which how more, like how much more will each have to contribute towards the purchase of the gift. So if this is, means you are going to minus this as well as this. That is D. So the first thing is D divided by, so that is capital D. So capital D, then divided by M minus 3. So M minus 3. Then after that, so M minus 3. Then again minus. So minus this D divided by M which we have taken. So that is D divided by M. So D divided by M. So then after that, so D divided by M minus 3 minus D divided by M you are supposed to do. And then after simplification, you will get it as the 3. So cross multiplication, you will get 3D divided by, that is 3D divided by M2. So M2 minus 3M. M2 minus 3M. So that is nothing but the option D. You will get the option D as the correct answer for this question. So next one is the 11th one. A person traveled 4 sides of a triangle with a speed of 100, 200, 300 as well as 400 km per hour. What is the average speed of whole journey? So what is the average speed of whole journey you are supposed to find? So the first thing is that there are 4 sides. So a person traveled 4 sides of a triangle. So that is there is a 4 into. So 4 sides of a triangle with a speed of. So distance equal to speed into time. Speed is given. So what you need to find is what is the average speed. So then the average speed of the journey is the distance of the journey which is divided by the time taken. So it is the distance of the journey, which is divided by the time taken. So if it is same length, and what will be the average? So average is that there is 4 sides, so it is 4 divided by, so average is 4 sides, so 4 divided by means whole divided by 4, and then into, so 1 divided by 100 plus 1 divided by, so 1 divided by 100 plus 1 divided by 200 plus 1 divided by 300 then plus 1 divided by 400. So this is the equation. So now we need to rearrange this. So 1 divided by 100, so 1 divided by 200, 1 divided by 300 and 1 divided by 400, and then you need to find the average speed of this. So that is 4 into, so then after that what you need to do is you need to multiply. So multiply each, so multiply, then after that you need to find the LCM. First you need to find the LCM of 100, 200, 300 as well as 400, and then after that you need to cancel everything and you need to write the result. So 4 divided by 100, so 100, 200, 300, 400, so and then, so you need to find the LCM of all this and then solve the equation. So upon simplification you will get it as 4800 divided by 25, which will be equal to 192 will be the average speed. So 192 kilometer per hour will be the average speed of the, so it will be the average speed throughout the journey. So next thing is the 12th question. 9 circles of diameter of each are in the square. So there is a, so in a square there are 9 circles. And of 2, so there are 9 circles of diameter of 2 are in the square, out of which 2 are in the square. And next thing is that find the height of a square. There are 3 rows each having 3 circles. So there are 3 rows. So there will be, so totally 9 circles in which there are 3 rows. So this is 1 row. So suppose consider these are circles like 1, 2, 3. Then there are 3 rows, 4, 5, 6. Similarly 7, 8, 9. So these are the 3 rows and then here we have 9 circles. So 1, 2, 3, totally 9 circles and they are arranged in 3 rows and each have a diameter 2. So they have told diameter is 2. So diameter is 2 and you need to find the height of the square. So height of the square is that. So first thing is there is a circle. So each is having, so there are 3 rows in the circle. So diameter is 2, so you need to find, so find the height of the square. So what is the height of the square? So these are stored in the square, so these are stored in the square and you need to find the height of the square. So height of the square is equal to, so height of the square is equal to 3 into 2, which we will get it as, so it will be 3 into 2, so 3 into 2 which is equal to 6. So 6 will be the height of the square. So then we shall see the last question. So the last question is that there are 215 liters of water. So then there are 215 liters of water containing 20% of alcohol. So there are 215 liters of water which are containing 20% of alcohol. And if we add 5 liters of pure water, what is the percentage of the alcohol? So first thing is there are 15 liters of water. So the total, so what is the, 15 liters of water is containing 20% of alcohol. So 20% of alcohol is the 20%, that is 20% into 15. So 20% into 15 is nothing but it is 20 divided by 100 into 15. So which is equal to 3 liters. Which is equal to 3 liters. And if we add 5 liters of pure water, so there are 3 liters and if you add the 5 liters, so that will be 3 plus 5, so 5 liters which will be equal to, so 8 liters. So it will be 8 liters. So next thing is that what is the percentage of alcohol? So now we add 8 liters of alcohol in the solution. So we add 8 liters of alcohol in the solution. Totally initially it was 15 liters. So we need to add 8 liters. So here it is 8 divided by, so 8 divided by 20 into 100. So into 100. So 8 divided 8 liters out of divided by there is 20% of alcohol. So 8 divided by 20, a divided by 20 into 100, that is, which is equal to, so 100 in percentage unit, so which is equal to 40%. So the 40% is the correct, so the 40% of alcohol is present in the solution. So 40% is the correct answer for this question. So in this video, we have discussed the aptitude questions that was previously, so that was asked in previously, and these are many repeated questions that was asked in KPIT. So in the next video, we shall discuss the verbal part as well as the MCQ questions. So thank you friends for watching, and do subscribe our channel for more updates.